Look, I'm able to connect to my Wi-Scan version 3 using the phone's hotspot, and you can see I can change the settings on the app. And this is with no Wi-Fi. How did I do it? Let's find out. Hello guys, Life Hackster here. Today, I just discovered something that is one of those the moment. Like, why didn't I think about this before? Anyways, this video is about setting up your Wi-Fi camera using your phone's hotspot. Now, in this setup, I'm using an iPhone 11. I actually did a video about this a while back, which I think this technique should have worked then. But I made it harder, requiring you to set up your Wi-Fi camera again and needing another Wi-Fi device, like another tablet, to set up the camera aside from a phone acting as a Wi-Fi hotspot. If you want to check that video out, I'll link it down below. But don't follow what I said on that video anymore, because this technique that I'll show you will be way better, faster, and not needing to reset up your camera or needing another Wi-Fi device. Okay, who is this video for? So if you have a property somewhere that there is no internet connection or even no power, you can set up a Wi-Fi camera that has local micro SD card recording like the Wi-Scams, or even better is bring your already existing Wi-Fi camera from home that you already set up using your home Wi-Fi to monitor your property. And another one is if you're setting up a time-lapse using your plugged-in Wi-Scam somewhere and there's no internet connection. You'll be able to access the Wi-Scam settings to set up the time-lapse just using your phone. I do get a lot of questions in this channel about setting up a Wi-Fi camera without internet. This might work for you. So if you already set up your Wi-Fi camera at your home, what you just need to do is just go to your phone settings. Click General and About, click on Name, and change this name to the SSID name of your home network, which is in my case is No Wi-Fi. Then go back to the phone settings, click on Personal Hotspot, toggle Allow Others to Join. Then change the Wi-Fi password to the password that you use in your home's network, and click Done. And that is basically it. Grab your Wi-Fi camera and bring it to wherever you want to set it up. And if you don't have any power, you can also use a power bank to power the camera. Now, this is just for short term though, and this will depend on the capacity of your power bank. If you have a standalone battery-powered camera like the Reolink Argus, then you don't even need a power bank, and it will record any motion events to its micro SD card. As to the plugged-in Wi-Scam, it needs to be constantly powered, but you can set it to record continuously or whenever it senses motion. So just power it up and wait for a couple minutes and the camera will automatically connect to your phone's hotspot. And you'll be able to access the camera, change the settings, or view recorded footage from its micro SD card, or set the Wi-Scam's time-lapse. Now the only caveat with this setup is that if you're not willing to leave your phone with a camera, then you will not get any motion notifications and you will not be able to access the camera if it is not within the hotspot range of your phone. But you can just leave the camera and whenever you come back and it's within the hotspot range, the camera will automatically reconnect. And then you can now access the camera's footage in the micro SD card and view motion events that happened even when the camera was not connected to the Wi-Fi hotspot, or view the 24/7 recordings that you set, or check the time-lapse footage. Now, one thing about the time-lapses though is that you will not be able to process the time-lapse with your phone that you are using the hotspot feature. You need to have another device to connect to the hotspot and have the Wyze app to process the footage or wait until you get back home and the camera and your phone is in the same Wi-Fi network to process the time-lapse footage. So you will only need a Wi-Fi camera that has a micro SD card recording feature like the Wi-Scams, Eufy Indoor Cams, or the Yi Wi-Fi cameras, and that has already been set up to your home's Wi-Fi network, and your smartphone that has a personal hotspot feature. And you'll be able to bring the camera anywhere, access the camera settings, and be able to record motion or continuous recordings to the camera's micro SD card, even if there is no Wi-Fi or internet connection. And with a power bank, you don't even need to have a plug-in power to where you're going to place the cameras. And for me, I can use my Wi-Scam version 3 and set it up in a tripod, connect it to a power bank, and access the camera settings so that I can set the time-lapse feature to get this footage. That's it. And any questions? Comment down below. Thanks for watching and I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. And click the bell notification so as to get notified when I upload tutorials like this video, product reviews, comparison videos, product updates, and long-term reviews. Thank you.